Welcome to another episode of Metro Matters. I'm Shivani Singh. Today we talk about celebrating our inheritance in the city of monuments, that is Delhi. I have with me Swapna Liddle, the convener of the Delhi chapter of INTACH, a non-profit organization that works in heritage conservation. INTACH has been preparing the brief for Delhi's claim to the UNESCO heritage tag. And she in fact met the chief minister recently to discuss this issue. So Swapna, tell us, what is the UNESCO heritage city tag all about?
India is a signatory to the Convention on World Heritage. And the idea is that UNESCO recognizes that, of course, there is a lot of heritage all around the world. Some of it is of national importance, some of it is of purely local importance. But there are some sort of heritage sites which are of importance not only to a particular nation but for the world as a whole. So to give you an example, Taj Mahal is obviously, it's not just a matter of pride and you know, an important piece of heritage for India, but all over the world it is recognized. So that UNESCO World Heritage status recognizes heritage all over the world. Now we've had World Heritage Sites. Of course, India already has a lot of World Heritage Sites, but the idea of nominating heritage cities, which is part of our, you know, modern cities, as heritage, this is a relatively new thing that has come about.
So it's obviously very prestigious to get this tag, but how does it affect the lives of people who live in these heritage areas?
Often people feel that a city becoming World Heritage is something like a monument becoming a World Heritage. And that actually is a misconception which has to be cleared, because when a monument becomes World Heritage, if the Red Fort is World Heritage, in fact, Red Fort also, it is, you know, pristine and untouched, and, you know, you have to maintain it as a monument simply because there are internal laws, not because of something UNESCO imposes per se. As far as the city is concerned, in fact, UNESCO recognizes that a living city has to undergo a lot of changes. It is a living city. It's a place where people live and work and earn their livings. So change is inevitable. So actually, if you get that tag, it is not as if everything will freeze and it'll become a museum. It won't. A lot of change still can happen. Most importantly, the laws which govern what kind of change takes place are laws which are already a part of that nation's, in this case, India's or the Delhi, you know, local municipal authorities or the state government, their own regulations and laws which govern how development will take place in the city, those are the ones that will apply. There's nothing external that comes from UNESCO.
So which parts of the city do you think can apply, or, you know, why for this tag?
This is a process that actually was gone into in some detail. We have sat with stakeholders, we sat with all sorts of experts who know how this nomination process works when we were preparing the dossier. And that process has obviously been over for some time. While doing that exercise, we finally narrowed it down to two historic areas. And those historic areas is the 17th century city of Shahjahanabad, Old Delhi, what we popularly know as, and New Delhi, which is again popularly known as Lutyens Delhi, the Lutyens zone. And the idea behind the nomination, how we framed this, was that Delhi has this great aura of power which developed over centuries, and this culminated in two major empires of the world, the Mughal Empire and the British Empire, building capital cities over here.
So it's not the first time that Delhi is planning to apply for this. In 2014, there was a dossier which was prepared with help from the INTACH, and it was the application was withdrawn. There were some concerns. So what were those concerns, and have they been addressed now that, you know, you're making a pitch again?
I think the concern was that this was the first time that one Indian city or had was applying for this kind of status. And quite rightly, I suppose there were some misapprehensions sometimes that, you know, what will this mean? The kind of issues that I've been talking about, that it'll stop development and we won't be able to make any changes and, you know, how will that impact future development? So those issues, those misapprehensions were there. And I think to some extent they have been cleared because now we have precedent. We have had three Indian nominations in this category, which have gone through Ahmedabad, Jaipur, and also Mumbai, the Art Deco Mumbai. So we have had parts of cities go in as a city nomination.
So recently you had a meeting with the Chief Minister of Delhi, and you've been trying to convince them to apply for the UNESCO World Heritage City tag again. What was the meeting like?
I think they are quite interested in reviving this. So let us see how it goes. Yeah.
There's apprehension that, you know, if you get a UNESCO heritage status, you know, you block all your redevelopment plans and nothing can take off.
If you look at Old Delhi, if you look at Shahjahanabad, you look at New Delhi, they both have their very distinct planning principles that went behind those. As far as Shahjahanabad is concerned, it's the pattern of narrow streets but havelis with courtyards, large amount of space which is within the haveli courtyard. It was a city that was meant for walking in. You could go from one end to the other because of those narrow streets. You have shade in the narrow seats, so it has a logic to it. New Delhi had its own logic, which was large open spaces, lots of greenery in the form of large trees, wide avenues, all that. Now, irrespective of UNESCO or whatever, it makes sense to conserve and preserve those aspects of the city. And these are the things that we identified that are worth preserving in the city. Because if you were to erase that, you would have a not only an ugly city, but a city which is considerably a loss to the people and their ways of life. If you get rid of all the havelis of Shahjahanabad and replace them with flatted complexes, it will be a disaster, I feel. Similarly with New Delhi, to preserve the low density, preserve the large number of trees, I mean, we all know how crucial it is today as a green lung for the city. When we are talking about preserving green areas, you know, preserving those old trees, it's an important resource for the city as a whole, which needs to be preserved. I mean, in fact, I disagree with people who on charges that this is an elite sort of a enclave which should be done away with. I think, no, we should preserve it, and for all of us, not only for the people who live there. So I think we should be preserving these anyway. And that's all that UNESCO wants from us. They don't want, if they were to give us the recognition, they wouldn't want to impose anything. They can't. We are a sovereign nation. They can't impose anything. So we will have to, it's us, we are saying we want to preserve this and we want recognition for preserving this.
It's one thing to get a prestigious heritage tag like this and another thing to retain it. So how do you think, you know, if we were to get a tag like this, you know, sustain this and...
In fact, one thing that we have been saying that this is going to benefit us in many ways. One is, of course, that the recognition brings you a lot of tourism. It puts the focus on you. You know, when people come to Delhi and they say, okay, what is there to see in Delhi? And apart from the UNESCO World Heritage Sites of Qutub Minar and Red Fort and Humayun's Tomb, they say there's a World Heritage City and they go and see it. That will increase tourism, etc. All that it does. It will also instill a sense of pride in the citizens to say that this is heritage, this is what, you know, we have got this heritage and we need to preserve it because we have this recognition. I think it will set up a chain reaction among the people, among the authorities to look at these areas differently, and they will work to preserve and retain that tag.
I hope we get success in this endeavor. Good luck to you, Swapna, and good luck to Delhi.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.